Okay. Good morning, everybody. I want to give you a warm welcome from the School of Civil Engineering from the Technical University of Catalonia. I hope that you had a nice trip to Barcelona and that you will enjoy these two meeting days here in these sessions. And also, probably we have some time to make some sightseeing in the city. That is all, for those that you don't know it, has many interesting things in the city, so welcome. Logistic things. There is an agenda for those that you don't have it with you. You can take it from the desk. And also, the sessions will be video and audio recorded, so it's important that all the speakers, whenever they talk, they use a microphone, either this one, any one of the microphones that are available in the room, because everything will be video and audio recorded. So it's a pleasure for us to have this workshop, the third workshop of this course action. And well, I hope that will be a lot of interesting presentations and discussions in order to get the action advance a step further. Thank you very much.
I also would like to welcome you here in Barcelona. I'm very happy that Juan Casas overtook the part of the local organizer. And yes, I'm also hoping for two interesting days with presentations, discussions, outcomes. And we will start now with some opening presentation by myself. Then this is also very important. We are going to hear about the cost action TU1406, where we have quite some similarities with, and we are looking here forward to the introduction by Juan Casas, and we hope that we can find some synergies and progress with an envisaged workshop between these two actions. Then we have a general session and the working group one session before lunch. So what now I'm going to do the opening presentation. Okay, so this was already the welcome to the workshop here. For the opening, we look to the second workshop in Istanbul last year. And this is actually the workshop which provided the basis for this workshop. You have seen in the agenda, in the program, that this workshop is quite filled. This workshop today and tomorrow. I've been having the first requests of how long the presentations should be. We will have rather presentations of let's say about 15 minutes, depending on the specific time of the session. But also we should take some time for discussion, as also stated in the agenda. Still keeping the time. This would be important. This was the comment by Juan Casas, so that we are on time for lunch, for instance. Okay, so the second workshop in Istanbul provided the basis for this workshop. Here we got started on preparing the fact sheets. We had their presentations of flow charts, the test cases, principal procedure, and actually some first fact sheets. We had also a very interesting activity, namely the questionnaire, where we asked the network for instance, what they are seeing as challenges in the value of information analysis. We have documented that on our website. This is quite some work at this point, thanks to Henning. He's overtaking the website editing and actualization. And if there's any issue on the website, please contact direct Henning or me. Okay, we have the questionnaire as an activity we have had. This then we made a plan for the development of fact sheets. And that was quite successful. That led to the workshop here and this rather crowded agenda. And this was also an issue last year. We needed to get the SDSMs started, the short-term scientific missions, so that people are going to another institution for a specific period of time. We have money for that. We can support that. So we got it started, and we have completed two short-term scientific missions by Dr. Maria Masciotta and by Ms. Simona Bogewska. So this was also an achievement of the second workshop in Istanbul. We had 44 participants, and we have, as I said, documented this workshop on our website. Unfortunately, the video recordings did not work this well, so we have only partly uploaded where we had the corresponding material. And here again, I have the username and password for downloading material which is only intended for inside the action. Okay, this was our second workshop. How did the network and budget develop? The network still increased. Well, last time we included two more countries who applied to be included. And I think we are the first cost action to have Montenegro in here. So this is a success for cost and for us. And our network, we have now 122 participants, a little increase due to two more countries and some intake of very few persons. We have been threatening with the fact that the budget will decrease. However, we have a slight increase of, I think, 5% or 4 or 5%. So our budget stays approximately constant. And this is the reason why the network should also stay approximately constant, so that that we can do the cost action on the level we are doing it first. And second, one boundary is the monetary capacities, but the other boundary is, of course, the management capacities, and they are also not increasing. So that's why we would like to have here the network staying like it is. If there's good ideas, if there's contributions, if there is a strategic point, then we are, of course, willing to take that up and to support. We are now in our scientific program here. In the second year, in the beginning of the second year, the tasks 1, 2, 3 corresponding to the working groups 1, 2, 3 are active, and then we have here corresponding the points which are taken up, and this is what I will come later to. This will be a point of our first intermediate report. We have to say what has been done for these points, which are here in this table, but they are also in the memorandum of understanding, and this is where COST looks into. These are the other two working groups, case studies, portfolio, and development of guidelines. Development of guidelines we will do later, but the case studies, portfolio, selection of case study, this is what should take place. But I think we are very active, thanks to Helmut Wenzel in that regard. I think there was also activity last year already. Okay, so this is what we have to keep in mind, the scientific program. And the key deliverables here, shorter audit version in regards to my last time opening presentation. So of course we have these dissemination activities. This is what we are into. We may take up training courses, we will see. Well-developed homepage, this is what we are working on, which we are, I think, also quite okay. Then it's a library of tools, and then a chapter of the probabilistic model code and the guideline aiming at practicing engineers. So this is what we have to keep in mind for our further activities. We soon have to deliver the first intermediate report. So this goes to the memorandum of understanding and what is written there and how the individual activities, how they were documented. So we were asked, for instance, for each workshop to deliver a workshop report. And if you are good prepared, like for this one, then this is good workable. This is what we have to keep in mind. This will largely prepared by myself, by the steering committee, but of course the management committee. If anybody has ideas from the network on what activity, how that a certain activity in the corresponding country should be documented, you are very welcome to send me an email pointing to this activity, and we will include this in the report. So some important future activities. The next workshop will be in conjunction with the MSS CE conference in August this year. We will also have a conference session at the European Workshop on Structural Health Monitoring. Thanks for the organization to Michael Döhler. This will be in July this year, I think we should also have a look at a very important event for the field of structural safety and reliability, the ICOSAR 2017. We are just about to to organize a session on value of information in structural health monitoring. So I think this is a very important event where we should and where we can impact. Okay, let's come to this workshop, aims and working focus for our third workshop. It's the presentation and consolidation of fact sheets. It's the presentation, then the discussion, and also the second point here, the structuring and further development of the fact sheets, and the preparation of the intermediate report. This would be the aims for this workshop. What are the deliverables? A workshop report, this will be largely composed of fact sheets. Then we have the presentations and audio and video recording, which we will put on the website. And all participants are also requested to give us ideas for further activities. It can be basically any of your interests, what you would like to pursue, and we will then find a solution how we can document this activity, and we will also help for that. And then we have the, this is cost abbreviations, it's the steering committee and the management committee. So here we need to draft the next work and budget plan. So our work and budget period ends in April. It starts, there will be a new one in May, lasting 1 year. And we need to make a plan for that, which workshops are we organizing, where, what are the topics, and what should we do about the short-term scientific missions, how do we advertise these, and so on. And of course, an outline for the first intermediate report. This goes mainly to the SC and MC. Okay, thank you for your attention. Let us have a good workshop. So we are now coming to the keynote presentation by Juan Casas.